are my father. Oh, how you love to love me. Oh, when I am sick, you are my healer. Oh, how you love to love me. My life is in your hands.
Oh,
victory belongs to Him. Who will stand against the Lord? No one can, and no one will. Who will stand against our King? No one can, and no one will. Oh, 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 oh. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Him. Oh, 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 oh. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs. Victory belongs to Him. Oh, 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 victory belongs to Him. Victory belongs to Him. So we put our trust in Him. So we put our hope in Him.
From a position of victory. Victory belongs to Jesus. victory belongs to him. Come on, clap your hands and give God praise wherever you are, because we are victorious. Put in that comment box, I am victorious. I am victorious. I am victorious. All those things that are not as though they were. We are victorious because we are in Christ Jesus. Well, I am Pastor D.S. Cullars, the founder and the senior pastor of the True Friendship Church. For we are one church in two locations, currently in Lincolnton, Georgia, and in Elberton, Georgia. And I greet you in the matchless name of Jesus. For those of you viewing us on Facebook, go ahead and hit that share button. Tag someone in this video to let them know that True Friendship Church is on live. For those of you viewing us on YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you have an Instagram account, follow us on Instagram. I am excited about what the Lord is going to do through our worship service this morning. And you are tuning in to the right service. You are at the right place at the right time. Well, it is often time in the sanctuary. It is time to give. And I am expecting God to do some great things in my life. This week I was talking with the Lord and I was asking the Lord about a few things that I want him to do in my life. And he challenged me. He said, Darabius, if you want me to do these things, I want you to give a little more than you normally give. The word of God is true. As long as the earth remains, there will be seed time and harvest time. That is a cycle that we cannot break. That's a cycle that cannot be broken. Regardless of what we do, that is a cycle that cannot be broken. Just like in a cycle in our climate, we have precipitation, evaporation, condensation. That is a cycle that cannot be broken. And it is a cycle in this earth. It is a principle in this earth. As long as the earth remains, there will be seed time and harvest time. I believe that is one of the ways that the Lord moves on our behalf, through our giving, through our seed, through our paying our offering and paying money in the church or in the kingdom of God. I believe that is one of the ways that God moves on our behalf. And I want God to move on my behalf. For those of you who are viewing our worship service for the first time or tuning in every week, I do not ask that you pay your tithes here. I ask that you pay your tithes wherever you are being fed. And primarily, for most, we are getting fed at our church home. So I'm not asking you to pay your tithe here at this ministry, but I am asking you if you would give a donation. True Friendship Church family, you know what you're supposed to do, and I ask that you hold up your end of the covenant and watch God keep his part of the covenant. The ways to give are on your screen, and I am excited about what the Lord is going to do through your giving. Give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men sow into your bosom. And I pray that your seed go and grow, and it accomplish that which it is set out to accomplish.
Hallelujah. How many of you love the Lord on this morning? How many of you really love the Lord on this morning? That I I love you more than anything. I lift my hands in total adoration unto you. You reign on the throne, for you are God and God alone. Because of you, my are gone, and I can sing to you this song. I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Love me in your arms. You are my shelter from the storm. When all my friends, you were right there all alone. I never known a love like this before. I just want to say that I love you more than anything.
Lord, I love you more than anything. Can anyone attest to that and say, Lord, I love you more than anything, more than my family, more than my friends, more than the house that I live in, more than a car I drive. Lord, I love you more than anything. Hallelujah. If I can be transparent, this week has not been the greatest week for me. Yes, as a child of God, I have good weeks and I have not so good weeks. I have some days where it seems like everything is going well, and then I can wake up on any given day and it seems like all hell has broken loose. Every day for me is not a petal of roses. Some days I experience some thorns. So this week wasn't a great week for me. And as I was driving this week to work, I began to talk with the Lord. And some of my best conversations with the Lord happens when I drive. So I began to talk with the Lord while I was driving. And I questioned the Lord. I did not question the Lord about who I am, because I know whose I am and I know who I am. I know my identity. So I did not question the Lord about who I am, nor did I question the Lord about what decisions I have made in my life. Two of the best decisions I have made in my life, one being when I accepted the Lord as my personal Savior. And the second best decision that I have made in my life is when I decided to marry Sierra Chantel Jones. So I did not question the Lord about what decisions I have made in my life, but I began to question the Lord about where I am. I wanted to know, am I working on the right job? Am I living in the right city? Lord, am I where you have destined me to be at this appointed time in my life? So I began to question the Lord, am I working on the right job? Am I living in the right city? Lord, am I where you have destined me to be? I began to question the Lord, and is there anyone out there that's viewing me this morning? Know what I'm talking about? Have you been to a place, or maybe you're there right now, that you question the Lord? Are you where you're supposed to be? And the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me through a passage of Scripture, Psalms 37. Psalms 37, verse number 23 says, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down. For the Lord upholds him with his hand. David said, I have been young and now am old. Yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his descendants begging bread. Let's go back to verse number 23, and there is where you're going to find my thesis for this morning. The steps of a good man or a good woman or a believer are ordered by the Lord. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. The steps of a good woman are ordered by the Lord. The steps of a believer are ordered by the Lord. And this morning, I want to preach about my steps. Woo! My steps. I want somebody to know that you are where you're supposed to be. I want a good man to know you are where you're supposed to be. I want a good woman to know you are where you're supposed to be. I want a believer in God to know you are where you're supposed to be. I want to talk about my steps. Hallelujah. My steps. My steps. I dare somebody to get up and start walking around your house with your cell phone in your hand and say, my steps. Let's pray. Spirit of living God, we thank you for your spirit. We thank you for what you're getting ready to do through our service this morning. Have your way. Minister to us. Touch us as we engage into your word. Let your word become flesh among us. God, your word is a living word, so let it relate to our situation right now. We thank you. Endow me with your spirit. Hide me behind the old rugged cross. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. My steps. Of course, there's no test without context. Therefore, allow me to put Psalms 37, verses 23 through 25 in its proper setting. King David is the author of Psalms 37. And the theme of Psalms 37 that David wants us to see is a contrast between the wicked and the righteous. The Jews during this time was questioning the Lord. Their question to the Lord was, will they inherit the blessings of the Lord in the promised land? When will the Lord intervene in their situation? Will the wicked continue to plot schemes against the righteous? And will the righteous ever get an advantage over the wicked people? So David wrote Psalms 37 to encourage the believers during that day and the believers today to let us know that we, the righteous people of God, we have the advantage. Whenever you have time, please read Psalms 37 and its entirety. But I love how Psalms 37 starts off. Psalms 37, verse number 1, it says, do not fret because of evildoers, nor be envious of the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herbs. David, let us know, don't worry about them. Don't worry about them. They're telling us righteous people. Don't worry about the wicked people, because sooner or later they are going to be cut down. They may be prospering right now, but sooner or later they're going to be cut down. Don't worry about it. So read Psalms 37 when you have time. Look, I want to zoom in at verse number 23. Verse number 23 says, the steps of a good man, the steps of a believer are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. Point number one, I want you to know, and I want to talk about, my course is set. Put that in the comment box. My course is set. My course is steps. For the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. In other words, the course of my life has already been predestined. God has already written my life story. He knows my ending and my beginning. He knows my trials. He knows my tribulation. So my course is set. My life has already been predestined. God has already already made every crooked place straight and every rough place smooth. My course has already been set. God has already read my life story. I'm just going through the motion because he has already read my life story. The course is set. Let's read a scripture. Ephesians chapter number 1, verses 3 through 6. Ephesians 1, verses 3 through 6 says, "Blessed be the God and Father of Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus." I want to start right there and let you know very quickly that God has some spiritual blessings stored up for you. God has put some blessings in your spiritual account. Let me go on. Just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. So before you were created in your mother's womb, before you were conceived in your mother's womb, the Lord had already predestined you. The Lord had already knew you. The Lord already knew you before you showed up. He had already set your course. He had predestined you to be here. So he had already put some blessings. Every blessing that you need right now. Every blessing that you need right now before you showed up. The Lord had already put those blessings in your spiritual account. And the blessings are already stored up in the heavenly realm. What we just got to do, we got to call those things in the heavenly realm. And we got to call them to be manifested in the earthly realm. Hallelujah. They are already deposited in our spiritual account. God knew what you need before you asked him. And so the Lord is just waiting for you to ask for your spiritual blessing and watch your spiritual blessing be manifested here down in earth. Hallelujah. Verse number 5, it says, having predestined us to adoption as sons by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, by which he made us accepted in the beloved. Hallelujah. God had already predestined us to be here. Hallelujah. And before we showed up here on earth, before I showed up on June the 19th, 1990, hallelujah, the Lord had already deposited every spiritual blessing that I need. Hallelujah. He had already put it in my account. Hallelujah. In the heavenly realm. So when I showed up down here on earth, he knew what I needed on September. He knew that what I was going to need on September the 13th, 2020. So the Lord said, it's already yours before you ask for it. Just ask. Hallelujah. And once you ask for it, I'll make your spiritual blessings, which are in the spiritual realm, be manifested down here in the earthly realm, because we were predestined to be here. Our course was set. Our course was set before we got here, y'all. Let me read another scripture. Isaiah 45, verses 2 through 3. Isaiah 45, 2 and 3, it says, the Lord says, I will go before you and make the crooked, hallelujah, the crooked places straight. I will go before you, before you even go through it, before you even show up, I will go before you and make the crooked places straight. I will break the pieces, the gate of bronze, and cut the bars of iron, hallelujah. In other words, God said, I kick down every door. Hallelujah. Every door that's closed, the Lord said, I kick it down. Hallelujah. I cut it down. Whatever I got to do to get you through the door, God said, I cut it down. I kick it down. I do whatever I got to do. Let's read on. I will give you the treasures of darkness and high and hidden riches of secret places. Hallelujah. I will give you the treasures of darkness and hidden riches in secret places. I will give you the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of secret places. That's good, y'all. That you may know that I, the Lord, who call you by your name, am the God of Israel. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God said, I will give it to you because I know what you need. I have already put them in the spiritual realm. I have already put them in heavenly places. I know what kind of blessing you need. I'm just waiting for you to ask. Hallelujah. I'm just waiting for you to ask because your course has already been set. I know what you need. If you just ask me, I'll give it to you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let's read one more scripture. Psalms 1, verse number 6. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous. The Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. The Lord said, I know every step you're going to take. Hallelujah. I know what you need, and I know everything you're going to go through. Hallelujah. Because I want you to know that your course has been set. Hallelujah. Your life has already been predestined. The course is set. My course is set. Somebody shout, my course is set. And I like the second part of Psalms 37, verse number 23. It says, and he delights in his way. When we walk in those steps that's already set, that has already been predestined, when we walk in that course that's set, and when we step in those footsteps that the Lord has already laid out before us, the Lord smiles and says, that's my daughter, that's my son. They're doing exactly what I want them to do. My course is set. Verse number 24 says, though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholds him with his hand. Number two, I want you to know, my failures are not permanent. My failures are not permanent. Put that in the comment box. My failures are not permanent. By my course being set by God, every blessing that I need, the only thing I have to do is ask God for, because they already have my name on it. And since my course has already been set, this also indicates to me that my trials and my tribulations have also been predestined. I just don't want you to shout about the blessings, but let me give you the flip side of that. My trials and my tribulations have also been predestined. One of the interesting stories to me is found in Matthew chapter number 4. And the Bible says, and Jesus was led up by the Spirit. And Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness. And Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. Wait a minute. Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil? Oh, yes. I want you to know that the Lord does not tempt us, but he does test us. So that lets me know that my trials, because we got to realize that the devil can't do anything to us until God grant him permission. The devil and his demons can't even touch you until God give him permission. Hallelujah. So that lets me know all of my trials, all my tribulations have been ordered by the Lord. And my failures are not permanent. Pastor Phillips, how do you know that our failures are not permanent? Because 1 Corinthians chapter number 10, verse number 13 says, no temptation has overtaken you except such as is common to man, but God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able. Hallelujah. But with the temptation will also make the way of escape, that you may be able to bear it. Hallelujah. The Lord said, listen, I have ordained and I have predestined. I have set the course not only for your blessings and your miracles, but for your trials and your tribulation. I have also predestined your trials and your tribulation. And when you go through your trials and when you go through your tribulation, God wants us to know he has also provided a way to escape. Hallelujah. When you have had enough, when you have had all you can take, the Lord says, since I have went before you, I have also provided a way to escape. I want to tell somebody, whatever you're going through, whatever trial you are in, whatever tribulation you are in, I want you to know there is a way to escape. God has provided a way to escape, because your failures are not permanent. Hallelujah. Regardless of what you have done, regardless of what decisions you have made, your failures are not permanent. Hallelujah. People may think that your failures are permanent, but what they do not know, that God is upholding you. God is upholding you. When you fall down, hallelujah, when you fall down, the Lord catch you before you get down too low. Hallelujah. And right at the nick of time, at the appointed time, the Lord let you rise up for a great comeback. Hallelujah. Somebody getting ready for a comeback, because you know right now your failures are not permanent. Regardless of what you have done, regardless of what it feels like, you ought to give God a radical praise, because your failures are not permanent. I feel the Holy Ghost moving. Isaiah chapter number 40, verses 30 through 31 reads, even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly what? Fall. Oh yeah, we're going to fall. But I wish I had a church to shout right now. But verse number 31 says, but those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint, because our failures are not permanent. Hallelujah. When I fall, the Lord catch me. Before I fall, I hear my mother-in-law, Minister Jackie Jones, say, he's a leaning post, and he won't let you fall. Before I get down, before I hit my head on the ground, the Lord catch me before I fall. Woo! Hallelujah. Glory to God. My failures are not permanent. Somebody give God a radical praise right there, because your failures are not permanent. Somebody put in the comment box, my failures are not permanent. Verse number 25 says, I have been young and now am I old. But David said, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his descendants begging bread. My third point I want to talk about, I am never forsaken. I am never forsaken. Throughout the Bible, you will see the Lord say, I will not leave you nor forsake you. In Deuteronomy chapter number 31, verse number 6, Deuteronomy chapter number 31, verse number 8, Hebrews chapter number 13, verse number 5, you will see that language. The Lord will say, I will not leave you nor forsake you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. And leave and forsake for us today seems like the same thing. Lord, are you being redundant? Why are you saying throughout the Bible, you will not leave me nor forsake me? Isn't leave and forsake the same thing? But I want you to know that leave and forsake is not the same thing. Leave is referring to physical presence. The Lord said, I will not leave you. I will not physically leave you. Forsaken means emotional presence. Hallelujah. I won't abandon you. So the Lord said, I will not leave you. I won't leave you physically, nor forsake you. I won't emotionally leave you. I'm there. Hallelujah. I'm there. Ooh, out of the bush. I'm there. Even in your trials, even in your tribulation. Pastor Cullars, even when you're not having a good week. Facebook, even when you're down. Instagram, even when you're going through sickness. YouTube, even when you don't know which way to go. The Lord said, I will not leave you nor forsake you. I won't leave you physically, and I won't abandon you emotionally. I won't leave you nor forsake you. And this scripture lets me know, hallelujah. David said, I once was young, but now I'm old. But David said, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken. David said, I've never seen the Lord leave his children emotionally. Not only is he there physically, but he's also there emotionally. Hallelujah. The Lord has never left his children, and he will never leave us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want you to know that with every step that you take, he's there. Hallelujah. With every move that you make, he's there. For every time you go up to the mountain, he's there. And if you go down to the valley, he's there. Oh, he'll give you bread when you're hungry. He'll give you water when you're thirsty. David said, I once was young, but now I'm old. Yet have I seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread, nor his descendants begging bread. The Lord, David, let us know, no matter what predicament that you are in, hallelujah, the Lord will be there. He'll provide for you. He won't forsake you. He won't leave you, because your steps have been ordered by the Lord. The Lord knows what you need when you need it. Your steps have been ordered by the Lord. I am not forsaken. I am not forsaken. I am not forsaken. I want somebody right now. Oh, I don't have no music, and I don't need music right now. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, when I think about this word, the word is just like fire. Shut up in my bowl. I want somebody to move around your house and say, my steps, my course is set. My failures are not permanent. Hallelujah. My failures are not permanent, and I'm never forsaken. Somebody else will walk around your house and say, my steps, my steps, my steps, my steps. Hallelujah. And as I close, the Hebrew word for steps means to shred. Or stride, excuse me, to stride. The Hebrew word step means to stride, to walk along, to march. And when you stride, you are making long steps. I don't know why I'm saying shred, but when you stride, you make it long steps, not baby steps. You're making long steps for the steps of a good man, for the steps of a good woman, are ordered by the Lord. Stride. I'm making long steps. I'm making long steps. I'm walking along. I'm marching along. And when I read this story, when I read this passage of scripture, and the Lord began to talk to me about the steps, my steps, I thought about a staircase. Thought about stairs, a flight of stairs. And my mind went back to my undergrad degree when I was at Payne College. And at Payne College, some of my classes were in a building that had about 4 flights of stairs. And sometimes my classes would be on the 4th floor. So I didn't want to wait on the elevator, because the elevator took too long, because a lot of people were trying to take the easy route. Oh, y'all missed that in spirit. The elevator took too long because a lot of people was waiting to take the easy route. So I took the stairs, and there were about 50 stairs I had to take to get from the 1st floor up to the 4th floor. Hallelujah. So I had to take the steps to get there. And if I wanted to make it to class, and if I wanted to make it to the 4th floor, I couldn't stay on the 1st floor. I had to make steps. Woo! I had to make steps. What I'm trying to get you to see is, the Bible says the steps, the stride, when you stride, when you make long steps, you can't go to the next level if you don't take any steps. The Lord won't bless you if you don't move. Some of you are afraid to move. Some of you are afraid to move. You too content where you are. You're comfortable where you are. But the Lord said, I need you to make some steps. I want to get you to the next level in your spirit, in your prayer life. Hallelujah. On your job, in your career. The Lord wants me to tell somebody, you can't stay where you are. You got to make some steps. The steps of a good man. The steps of a good woman. Lord, if I want to go higher, Lord, if I want to go to the next level, I got to take some steps. I got to take some steps. Woo! Not in the baby steps, but I got to take some long steps. I got to stride. Come on, stride, y'all. I got to step. Woo! I can't stay where I am. If I want to go to the next level, if I want to go to the fourth floor, in order to get to the first floor, from the first floor to the fourth floor, I got to take some steps. He walks with me. And he talks with me. And he tells me that I'm his own. I said it again. He walks with me. And he talks with me. Woo! And he tells me that I'm his own. I got to take some steps. And realize that my steps have been ordered by the Lord. My course is set. And if I fall, my falls, my failures are not permanent. Because I'm going to get right back up. Because I realize I am never forsaken. I tell somebody, wherever you are, let the devil know that you get ready to take some steps. Because your steps have been ordered by the Lord. That's all the Lord wants me to tell you on this Sunday morning. Realize that your steps have been ordered. My course is set. My failures are not permanent. And I am never forsaken. I dare you. You just walk around your house. Woo! Let the devil know. Hallelujah. If you got to pull over, pull over. They may look at you like you're funny. But let the enemy know and let the world know that you're taking some steps. I'm going high. I'm going high. I'm going high in the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm leaving y'all this morning. But I want y'all to know that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. My steps. Hallelujah.